Good morning, everyone. This is a very special presentation which we have to commemorate Remembrance Day, which is always on November 11th. We would like to welcome everyone to our Remembrance Day ceremony. Emmy and I, in our role of school captains, will be leading the proceedings. I will now ask Emmy to explain the meaning of Remembrance Day.
Remembrance Day is a day that commemorates the end of World War I. 100 years ago, on the 11th of November 1918, the guns of the Western Front fell silent after 4 years of continuous warfare. The armistice, which means the countries would stop fighting, was signed, bringing to an end the First World War. On the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month, the armistice was signed. At this time, we remember all Australians who fought, died, and suffered in World War I and all following wars. After World War II, the name was changed from Armistice Day to Remembrance Day. We hold special ceremonies all over the country. Often a military band will play, wreaths are laid, and above all, there is a minute of silence. Every year, nations around the world fall silent for 1 minute at 11 a.m. on the 11th day of the 11th month, to remember those who have served their country during war. During the minute of silence, we commemorate all Australians who served in all wars, conflicts, and peace operations in which Australia has participated.
I'd like to introduce Ronan and Mark to read the poem in Flanders Field. The poem was written by John McCrae, a soldier after witnessing the death of his friend in World War I.
In Flanders fields the poppies blow, between the crosses row on row, that mark our place and in the sky, the larks still bravely singing fly, scarce heard amid the guns below.
We are the dead, short days ago. We lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow. Loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe, to you from family hands we go. The torch be yours to hold it high, if ye break faith with us you die. We shall not sleep, though poppies glow in Flanders fields.
Scarlett will now talk to you about the meaning of the Ode of Remembrance from the poem For the Fallen, and then read it to you.
The Ode of Remembrance comes from the poem For the Fallen. It was written by Lawrence Binyon, an English poet and writer, after one of the earliest battles of World War I. This was the Battle of the Marne and took place 48 kilometres from Paris, which is the capital of France. Tens of thousands of soldiers died. The Ode of Remembrance is regularly recited at memorial services held on days commemorating World War I, such as Anzac Day and Remembrance Day. They shall not grow old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them, lest we forget.
The last post will now be played. This is a tribute to the fallen, the men and women who died during times of war. Immediately after the last post has played, we will have 1 minute of silence, where we can reflect on and honour the people who fought in the war. At the end of the minute of silence, we will play the rouse, which means the breaking of a new day, and is a shorter bugle call that was also used to call soldiers to their duties. Would everyone please stand and remain standing in silence for the last post, the minute of silence, and the rouse. attending today's Remembrance Day ceremony.